forge ahead for Philadelphia. Joffrey Leupold, open man Hartnell, he scores. Scott Hartnell with a terrific rifter.
That was high heat at its best. The Flyers broke out of the zone on a 3-on-2, and the opportunity knocked for Hartnell, who just rips it into the top corner under the bar. Nicely done on the attack. Scott Hartnell gets his 22nd goal of the season. Here it comes, and it's all Leupold. Look at this feed in the neutral. He gets around Bradley, Leupold across to Hartnell, and that is a dart. He used a little bit of Tom Pody as a screen. The goaltender Theo didn't pick it up. The Caps line out there, Gordon, along with Brash. And Bradley didn't pick up the late guy, and he puts her top shelf.
Tomas Fleischmann back in for Washington. Hartnell does most of his damage at Wachovia Center, including this season a hat trick against Washington's expense and a Philadelphia win back in December. Now David Steckel working off the boards. Eric Fair trying to stop. Nidamaki holds the post in the crease, and the referee Lecuyer blows the play dead.
A great job by Eric Fair taking it to the hoop. That's an aggressive offensive thrust by Eric Fair. And you mentioned his run of late, Joe. He's been one of the real nice stories here in Washington this season. The way he stepped in with Chris Clark going down, other guys were getting ice time. He took the advantage, 11 points the last 11 games. Just about another goal for Eric Fair. He had time. Good job by Giroux. Should have been a minor penalty for holding. Doesn't go that way. Giroux prevents Fair, I think, from putting that puck past the right leg.
Capitals had the first two goals of the game tonight. Baxter in the first, Ovechkin made it 2-0 in the second. Then Giroux cut the lead in half before the second period was over. Scott Hartnell has just tied it for Philadelphia here in the third. Mike Vogel, WashingtonCaps.com, reminded us the last time the Caps beat the Penguins and Flyers in consecutive regular season games, you got to go way back to 1996 in his research.
How does he have time to figure all that stuff out?
That's got to be a lot of pages to turn.
He is the man when it comes to stats and stuff like that. Good stuff on Mike Vogel's blog and all the stuff he does on the Capitals website. Just terrific.
Fedorov finding Semin. Semin holds. His wrister was blocked. Mike Green jumping in. Green has never put up a point against Antero Nidamaki. Now would be the time. As Schultz drops it into a corner. Takeaway, Gagne. Swivels that pass right to awaiting Sergei Fedorov. Nylander drops it to the center stripe, and Parent crushes it in. As both John Stevens and Bruce Boudreau change him up on the go. Schultz on the eve of his 23rd birthday out there defending. Hartnell to the front, Leupold, pad save, rebound, they score! Carter!
Talking about Carter and his little mini slump, not really scoring in his last five games. Well, he puts one in here, and the Caps had time to clear it. Mike Green looked dog-tired going to the corner. It was checked by the Flyers. Watch what happens. The puck is kept alive. Hartnell, who just got on the board, he's going to get a primary assist along with Leupold. And there's the recovery opportunity for the goaltender, Theo, coming from right to left. Couldn't get across in time, even trying to throw his stick to try to stop that puck. But no way he was going to stop Carter on the doorstep just like that. 1, 2, 3 in a row, the Flyers have the lead.
Jeff Carter has some nice numbers against the Caps in his career, but that's the first goal he's ever scored against Jose Theodore, and he gives the Flyers three straight and a 3-2 lead. Ovechkin pulls the trigger, he just missed on the short side. Carter putting pressure on Pody now. Jeff Carter taking down. Pody sends it on around for the grade 8. Ovechkin just jamming with Upshaw. Upshaw goes down in a heap. Leupold moving in with momentum. Slapper coming high and hard from Claude Giroux. Now Coburn sends it on the way right to the breadbasket of Yurkina. 8.5 to go in regulation. Flyers on the road where they've won their last three. Have a one-goal advantage now in D.C. Ovechkin full throttle. Ovechkin, beautiful move. Back backhander denied by Nidamaki.
Yeah, just a wonderful move using that between the skate play to himself around Colburn. He's a tough guy to get around because he has great mobility.
Yurchina latches on to Giroux. Steckel has Powell under wraps, and Eric Fair should be able to clear. Eric Fair got it only to the center line where Matt Carr was on patrol for Philip. Powell to dump it in. The bench is asking for the line change. Mike Green, Washington's ice time leader, revs it up through center. Green, hearing it again from the fans, got cut down. Referees say play on. Both Dvorsky and Lecuyer. We're not reaching for the whistles there. Metropolit put some sauce on that, steered into the corner by Theodore with 7.5 to go in the third period. Asham walking in. Asham scores!
Delayed penalty against the Washington Capitals on that play. Asham, real nice play, holding onto the puck and then just firing it under the sprawled Theodore. The Caps rattled right now. They had the 2-0 lead. They should have scored on the power play. 7 had a great chance, and here come the Flyers. Metropolit, puck is deflected. There's the penalty that was going to be called. The puck is kept alive, and what a move. This guy's more known for his toughness and his fists. There, it's a goal scorer's goal. Aaron Asham gives the Flyers a 2-goal lead here in the third.
All of Asham's goals at even.